In this session, let's learn how to recover a non-system data file. Okay, let's create a table customer with customer ID number and let's store it in the table space users. Okay, let's insert row customer values 1. Insert into customer values 2. Let's commit and then let's check the rows. Okay, we have 2 rows. Okay, now let's check the data file related to the tablespace users. So select file name from DBA data files where tablespace name equal to users. Okay, the data file is disk2prod1data/user01.dbf. Now let's open the terminal, let's switch to Oracle user. And then let's go to disk2prod1 data folder. And then if you look here, we have the user01.dbf file. Okay, now let's delete that user01.dbf. It's deleted and it's not present. You see, user01.dbf file is not present. Since this is a non-system data file, we need not shut down the database. If it is a system data file, we need to shut down the database because we have all the data dictionary table and database related information in the system data file. We need to shut down and then recover the data file. But since this is a data file related to the user's data, we don't need to shut down the database. Even though it is important to the users because it contains the user's data, it is not important for Oracle database to function. Okay? So now let's go to our backup location, which is disk1/hot/backup/data folder. And here, if you look, we have the user01.dbf. And we took the backup on April 27th at 20:05. Okay. And the latest file which we had was as of April 28th, 23:05. That means almost 24 hours has passed since our last backup. Lot of operations might have been performed by the users. They might have inserted data, deleted data, updated data. If we recover the user01 data file from yesterday's backup, will we lose all the users' data which happened from yesterday? And no, Oracle will help us. Since our database is in archive log mode, and we have all the archive redo logs and the online redo logs, Oracle will take the backup copy of user01.dbf and then apply all the archive redo logs and then apply all the online redo logs to bring it to the current state. Yes, it brings to the current state. Okay, let's do that. So let me copy users01.dbf to disk2prod1 data folder. We copied. Now let's go back to the database and put the tablespace in the offline mode. Alter tablespace users offline. So the tablespace is in offline mode. Now let's recover the tablespace. Recover table space users. Why don't Oracle automatically do the recovery for us? So let's say auto and then run it. You see here it applied all the necessary archived redo log files and the online redo log files to bring it to the current state. Okay, if you want, let's query the customer table and check the rows. It says cannot be read at this time. Okay, we have put the table space in the offline mode, right? So let's bring that back. Okay, alter table space users online. Now the table space users is in the online mode. Now let's query the data from the customer. And you see the two rows which we created just now are present. That means Oracle has done a good job. It has taken the backup copy from the 27th April and then applied all the archive redo logs and the online redo logs to bring it to the current state. Cool, right? Yes. Please practice this so that you feel confident. Okay?